Hello. Hello, Chad. How y'all doing? I haven't turned on the player character sounds yet because they're chatting about something I don't want to have on my stream. You still can't hear them. Now they're reprimanding me because I haven't turned their audio on. Slander, spleen. I am gonna turn on their audio now if they behave. Are you guys gonna behaving?
We've always been behaving. I don't know why you keep telling your
yeah.
Your
I don't know. You're
that we're being
slanders. You're the slanders and lies here.
Yes.
We are having good, wholehearted conversation. About. We are having great conversation.
You're having great conversation.
We were talking about the history of the cornucopia, you know, for Canadian Thanksgiving, you know, the Fruit of the Loom thing. But no, that's too much for Kath, and we're all bad.
It's not you were talking about at all.
You know what, Kath? You don't get a baby old cheese now.
I don't get a big old cheese?
A baby bell cheese.
I don't like
it. Is that the one with the wrapper on it?
Well, and it's the one with the, other.
That's
yeah.
Wax.
The one with the red wrapper on it?
Those you're things not wax.
I don't eat the red part.
No, that's the best part.
Yeah, have it splayed. Don't eat the red part.
I'm telling you not to eat the wax.
So, hi, Veinless. So today we are going to be continuing our adventure against the Spirit Tree. When last we left our heroes, they had just cracked the outer core. Let me go ahead and I will, where's my, hang on. I have a thing for this, hang on. As the final blow strikes the ancient corrupted tree, the entire forest seems to hold its breath. A deafening crack echoes through the air as the tree splits open, revealing a swirling energy trapped in its core. Dark tendrils of shadow start to, like, stretch out of it. And inside, you see a grotesque, twisted souls inside with raw, glowing eyes, and its wails begin to pierce the air as it sheds the outer skin of this tree. All of the spirits that this tree has consumed for who knows how long have now been merged into one demonic spirit, and it is looking at the party as its initial main course. So here's where we are, chat. this is where we are, and these are our party members. Now, we were gonna go from the top of the order, but since we do have a new dude, he's going to roll, and we're going to see exactly where he now sits on our list. So
hopefully last.
Yeah, he sits last. There we go. But he does seem a lot more mobile than the last one. Just so you know. So from the top of the order, Red, you see that Verdant had kind of cracked the outer shell of this and it split into pieces, and inside you see this swirling mix of spiritual death. What do you want to do?
I wasn't prepared to go first, I'll be honest with you.
I'm sorry.
Ah, hell.
See, you made him socially awkward.
My man, she didn't do that. I was socially awkward long before I even met her.
Shush, I'm trying to help you.
I think what I'm going to do... Where's... Okay, that's... It's... That's its box here.
Uh-huh.
Was Verdant still in its mouth?
Didn't
Verdant eat it?
Is Verdant being chewed on currently?
No. Verdant got out. He is outside of the tree right now. And even if he was still getting consumed, the tree falling to pieces, he's no longer being consumed. Everyone who was grappled or might still be grappled is no longer currently grappled.
Okay.
Which I believe is also you, Red. You are no longer grappled.
Yeah, I was definitely grappled.
Has the has that area around him dissipated?
No. In fact, it seems to have gotten stronger.
So we'll probably need to stay close to Verdant anyway.
If Verdant can take a step back, he can get Isaac. But Verdant
could
goes
I use
last.
My move, reach out and grab Verdant and wrestle him? Because he's not grappled anymore, right? Or is he still grappled?
He is not currently grappled, no.
He's technically not last anymore.
Except his character's under the tree and I'm having a hard time grabbing. Hang on.
Gotta pull the tree away, grab Verdant.
I just want to use one of my attacks to grab and pull him away.
Okay.
Just gonna strap Verdant to my back.
So, he doesn't want to leave because he wants to continue fighting the tree. So you'll have to grapple him and pull him.
Oh no, a strength check. Do you think you can do it, Red? Who is raging?
Come here.
Well... Now, hold on.
Yeah, I'm at 20. I'm at 22.
Technically, Red did get higher because he has a plus eight to his athletics. Just, all right, we're throwing the nat 20s out.
I guess, yeah, if it boils down to two nat 20s, it would be the one with the higher score. So, Red, you grapple, like, the back of Verdant's cloak and yank him back, what, one square?
I want to get him out of, you know, underneath of the thing.
Uh-huh.
So, beside me would be great, if I can.
Uh-huh.
Like, I'll sacrifice all my movement to make sure he gets there, because I don't plan on... Whoa.
Sorry, I can't grab him. There we okay. go.
Yeah. Because I don't plan on moving from here.
It's breakdancing! I was not prepared for breakdancing trees!
I couldn't grab him. He was under the tree. There we go. We're fine.
Red, this wasn't in the manual.
So there's his aura. There's the tree's aura. I can't change its color. Sorry.
So now that I know that he's not going to get, like, munched immediately on the tree's turn.
Yeah. Unless he runs right back into it.
I'll just spend the rest of my turn just hitting him if I can.
Okay. So you have grabbed Verdant. I will say that that was probably your whole action to get him out of the tree's reach.
Okay.
Because you had to grab and pull. So you would have, like, a bonus action left.
Well, I need to keep that rage up. 17 to hit.
You're blessed?
Oh, I am blessed. Thanks, Elise. 18.
With Elise's god, you are allowed to hit it because a 17 would have missed.
Okay, so I got bonus from you. You're wounded. 2d6.
This tree is not wounded.
The tree is not wounded?
He is no longer wounded. No, this is a completely new thing. Okay. You killed the thing that was holding this.
Oh, Jesus.
This is the soul.
Get wounded.
Do wounded things.
Okay. Now the tree is wounded.
Get wrecked, nerd.
And
how did you
be
hit
my...
it? Out of curiosity, what did you hit it with?
Holy hand axe.
Holy chop chop.
See, the second d6 would be 2 holy damage.
I'm just checking its resistances and weaknesses. Hang on.
We find a demon resistant to radiant damage. We are
I'm
so screwed,
just
guys.
Checking.
I'm like, we are leaving.
There's a very big list here. Hang on.
You know, Lisa, I saw a cliff over there would make a great house for all of us. Away from this.
Okay. So, no, we're good, but he's not weak to radiant, not according to this.
That's fine. Just in case you needed it separated, I told you.
Okay, so we're good. You don't need to separate radiant and all of that for future reference. So we are good to go. Ready to go. I might have made a mistake. Okay, next up on the list...
Last time I heard Isaac. That, I ended up, you guys are level such and such, right? No.
You guys are level 14, right? No cap. We're 12. Oh.
I don't like that conversation, Cap. All right, is it my turn now? Fine.
Yes, it's your turn, Isaac.
I am going to move up. Hold on, I clicked the right thing there. I'm going to move up.
You can't move up that far. If you hover over him, you can see his box.
Okay, yeah, now I can see his box.
So you get, like, here.
Bah. Game is paused. God is telling me
no.
Oh,
sorry.
Boop. All right.
Question. I don't think you can flank this creature.
Hold on. I would have to go...
No. I think he's over too big there. For you all to properly flank. I think you'd have to be, like... its size to flank it.
Yeah, that's like a whole walk around the back there.
That would be like two ants coming up to you and like, yeah, I have flanking. No, that's not how flanking works.
Well, I mean, you'd still have flanking, but it, you know, their damage is not going to be as much. Like, it's going to be a little bit more than what they would have, but still ants.
Yeah, don't worry about it. Okay. So what are we doing, Isaac? Wounded severely, crying. Isaac? Isaac, just so you know, being next to Verdant, that aura that's kind of like in this area that caused you fear last turn, Verdant's aura is suppressing that. So you don't have to roll. But you know that if you leave his aura, that will be a problem.
Okay. All right, we may get some weird stuff here in a second. I swung and then nothing happened.
Uh-huh.
Bah. Okay. D&D, D&B Beyond is being broken at the moment.
Have you tried refreshing?
Like, I had to log in. I'll refresh the page. Oh, wait, no, because I was already logged out when I got into this. Let me hit the out. Jump into everything. Loading, downloading. Be real upset if my buttons didn't work, because I'm spoiled like that.
Spoiled.
Yeah, my buttons aren't working. For some reason, it's pulling up to the other thing. All right, hold on. Let me... It's 1d12 plus 6.
Are you saying your buttons aren't working even after refreshing?
Yeah, like, I've got the regular buttons. Like, I can do a wisdom one here. That works. If I go down to my axe and I do shift and I hit it, instead it brings up the great axe like thing. So like, let me see if I can just do regular. Nope, just brings it back up. Can I do damage? Nope. Yeah, all I've got is these top pieces. Let me see if I can do a saving throw. I can do a saving throw. How about my skills? Skills work. So yeah, currently the only... Let me try my javelin. Nope, it's just my actions for some reason. Just my weapons.
I don't know how you broke that. You want me to click it for either. You?
Yeah, sure. I'm double swinging with my axe there. Doing the advantage.
Okay. Great axe. How do you usually do your advantage?
I just do the shift, and it gives advantage on it.
And it's your great axe?
Yeah, I have a great axe plus 2.
There you go.
Thank you. So,
stop.
29.
Okay, yeah, that's fine. Why are you giving them the good rolls, huh? Yeah, it works and for I'll me. I don't know.
I'll do this. Boop. Okay, there's that. Plus two for the rage, plus... So one or two for my thing.
I don't know. How much damage doth thou do, sir?
1d6. So that's that one. So 14, 15, 16, 17, and then I got my radiant damage coming in, plus we also have his conquerors coming in for 1d6 plus 1d4 for another 8. So 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25.
Chat, welcome to Isaac Does Math. Here we go.
I'm not very good at it. More of a hands-on kind of guy. This is some bullshit.
Here we go. And Isaac, you got 25.
Yeah.
How'd you get 25? I see a 14, a 1, and an 8. That doesn't come up to 14, 25.
Yeah, my rage and my giant's might aren't added into that.
I see. There you go.
So the rage plus the giant's might, then the giant's might is the 1d6.
Mm-hmm.
And then the 1d6 for my axe's holy damage that you gave it, and 1d4 because of Verdant.
Mm-hmm. Okie dokie. Good. Well, is that all you want to do? Or you want to attack again?
I would like to attack again.
Is that another great axe?
Yes, that'd be another great axe.
I'm so angry. Yes, that hits.
Let's see if I can do this real quick. Plus two. Plus. D6. Yeah, that should be all that, and then I just have to roll the extra damage afterwards. Boom, okay. Rolled. 17 plus, here comes the radiant. Another 7. And that'll be all I have, which gives me a good moment to go in a notepad and write my code out that I have to have.
And you said that ends your turn?
It pains me to know when that you guys don't roll all your dice together.
Yeah, I understand. Abaddon, it's your turn.
No way.
What would you like to do?
What can I do? That's a good question.
I don't know. You have this great evil spirit demonic tree.
See that.
That's created from the souls of the eaten. And the danged.
Mm-hmm.
The darned.
How are we all looking, by the way? How are we all looking?
What do you mean?
Eyes? Yeah.
Looking about a fourth of what I usually do.
You see what...
I'm like 1/4?
Yeah.
Yeah. Remember when we started combat, mm-hmm. Isaac ate those.
Yeah,
shots.
I forgot about that.
Yeah. Kind of started this battle on Nightmare plus one.
That's not my fault.
At the risk of
okay, I'm gonna move loud, here.
I'm doing pretty good.
Oh yeah,
I'm pretty sure I enter its range, Gath. Now I think. I do, yeah.
If you are there, mm-hmm. This is inside Verdant's circle of you can't touch my friends.
Oh, good.
It's a good circle. I like that circle.
So this is the tree's circle. And you stepped inside a verdant circle within the tree's circle, so you can't be feared as long as you're within this circle.
Good. Okay. I will put my hand out to Isaac, and I'll say, "We need you up, buddy. Please feel better." And I'm gonna cast fifth level cure wounds on you.
Yay.
Ooh.
22. It's not the best.
I mean, it's pretty good.
I'll take it.
That's 44 more points that he can take before he dies.
I feel like I'm about halfway back to my normal self.
Yeah, I'm still glowing, by the way. Oh, wait. I need to not... Wait. Fuck.
You already did it.
Hold on. God damn it. No, I forgot I was glowing super bright.
You
Hold
are.
On.
The light show's done.
I should. Can I say don't look at me?
No.
Okay, no. Any creature that ends its turn. No, it's fine. It's fine. Any creature that ends its turn. I'm not going to end my turn next to you. You're fine.
That's damn. What you look like, but I turned it off because it's too bright.
Yeah, I'm very bright. Yeah, no, I'm a beacon, bro.
I'm a beacon. Another fey roll because you didn't get a leveled spell?
Huh?
Do you get another fey roll check?
No. It's a charged once. It's only once.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Okay.
If I don't have the Wild Magic Sorcerer Origin, I can only do it once.
That's fine. Is there anything else you want to do?
Did I leave its threat range?
No.
Does it have a 10-foot reach?
Well, maybe. Hang on.
Because if so, then yes.
It actually has a 15-foot reach, so... So I haven't, you're
I haven't
still
left
inside
it. No, yeah, I haven't left. I haven't left it yet.
No,
we are fine.
You're still in its threat range.
Never left.
That sucks, though. Yikes!
Yeah.
Are you being glowy?
I'm
he
very glowy.
Glowy.
I think I'm just gonna get back some sorcery points here.
Mm-hmm.
And then on my turn, I get back three.
Okay. I'm fairly certain Elise had her divine weapon up, right?
She did make a divine weapon, yes. The glowy boy, yeah,
it's,
she did do that.
It's under the dude, isn't it, right now?
I think so, probably, yeah.
It's just underneath him, smacking
around. She put it
around.
In his face.
The tree's face.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, there it is. Hang on, let me just grab that really quick. Hang on. There we go. Hang on. Nobody panic. Hang on.
I'm panicking.
There we go. Okay. I was like, where did her thing go? I know she had a thing somewhere. There it is. Okay. Elise is going to continue swinging with her spell, which was a spiritual weapon. Elise, honey. She missed.
She has a lot going on in her mind.
She can't tank everything for you all. Okay, well, she's still only level 6, so that's all she can do. it's Verdant's turn. Verdant said...
Be glowy.
Stay as close to teammates as possible to protect them with aura and maintain Crusader's Mantle. Keep third spell slot in case anyone dies and blast the tree with Divine Smite with every other one, pretty much, as he said. Okay.
Yes.
Yes.
Real quick.
Uh-huh.
Do you have, like, about how tall this tree is?
Let me look in the notes. It doesn't say in the creature's description how tall it is. So we're gonna say he's probably about... 50 feet tall, but it's kind of wibbly wobbly because the spirits are constantly like moving in and out, so he ranges anywhere from like 40 to 60, so 50 is like the middle range.
Yeah, so I remember I was telling you that I was going to try and find the actual size, because I had to go to a different book to find the size.
Uh-huh.
This thing is known as a colossal 2.
Yeah.
And to put that in perspective, colossal 2 are big enough that in this book, the things that are colossal 2 are big enough to house a couple families. And still fight. So I just thought that was interesting.
That is very interesting. I don't think you want to live in it, though.
No.
Okay, so Verdant is going to attack with his weapon. I didn't mean to. I was so used to doing Isaac's that I accidentally. Okay, hang on. He would have hit either way. So we're just going to use both of those attacks for both of his attacks. So there. So he hits with the first one, hits with the second one. So we're going to do his damage twice. So it is 1d10 plus 3 plus 3 plus 6, or it comes to plus 6. Then he has his 1d6 from what everyone should have on their weapons that he has never rolled. And then he has the mantle.
And you know, the mantle bad thing gives about it 1d4. Is, I could almost swear that he didn't get that. Like, I could almost swear that I remember you telling him he didn't get it.
It's possible. I'll think about it.
It's like, it might be why he never had it. Because I don't think he was with us when he put the items in the...
No, he was.
He was. We did it in secret because we were technically, and I quote, robbing graves.
You were.
I didn't rob shit.
Yeah,
that's where Abaddon got his blood, too. You guys are silly. Okay, so Verdant did a smash with his halberd. That's the damage that he did with both of his attacks. And then he's going to do his polearm mastery. God, I was almost a natural one, thank you. And then, I'm sorry, and then this. Okay, 16 with his polearm mastery. I seem to be rolling better than he does. That's fine, we're good. Okay, so that's his turn. Now it's my beautiful tree's turn. Are you guys ready for my tree, my demonic spirit to attack?
Time to die.
Hold on, I didn't sign up for it to fight back.
No, so, it's a tree. Cap, you're so silly. It's a tree. It can't move.
You're funny.
Funny enough to not get hit? Huh?
No.
Well, I tried, guys.
If it matters, all of his attacks count as magical weapons, if it matters at all to anybody. Just putting that out there, okay?
Hold on, could I have... What is the effects that make me paralyzed again? I couldn't have done any of that last turn.
You're not paralyzed.
I was still paralyzed.
Why are you paralyzed?
Didn't he do something to me?
No. When the tree's visage crumbled, no one was paralyzed anymore because the roots that was holding everybody shattered.
Okay.
Nobody was paralyzed last turn.
Why was I paralyzed? I still have the paralyzed condition.
Okay.
No, keep going. I'm looking at this.
No, that's okay. So currently, everyone within 20 feet of the creature needs to roll me a dexterity saving throw, please.
Oh, we are blessed.
Twice?
I'm sorry, what?
You said dexterity saving throw twice?
Just once.
Okay.
We do have bless, though, so...
And I'm a barbarian, so I have advantage on it.
That was almost a one. Hey, 19.
Roll your thing, Isaac, just in case.
Oh, frick. Oh,
bro,
God!
No! You kill the people who aren't here all the time. It's always the people who aren't here. What are you doing to my boy?
To
quote Kath, and I quote, not her fault.
Yeah. It's not my fault. So we all got a 19 on deck saves, which is actually really funny, except for Verdon.
Does someone else want to roll for him while he's not here?
Yeah, maybe, yeah.
No, I don't want that responsibility.
I'll roll for Verdon. I'll roll for him. My fellow Canadian
I'd rather
man.
Like, hey, buddy, there's nothing we can do. The DM killed you. There's nothing we can do.
No,
I don't
want to
be like, hey, man, they gave me the reins. And
am I rerolling this, Kath, or am I killed your horse. That?
What does the party say? I will leave this up to the party. Do we allow Abaddon to roll for Verdant this session, or do we keep my rolls? What say the whole party?
I mean, I had to go through a lot of damage.
Fair.
Yeah, because of her.
Why Verdant get special treatment?
I mean, it has to be a unanimous vote, and if Isaac withholds it, then I get to keep rolling.
Do you allow me to roll for my fellow Canadian man? Or do we want the one to control everything to roll for him?
I mean, in all honesty, are you going to be all right?
I mean, to be fair, I think it shouldn't be any of our decisions but Verdant's.
That's fair.
Yeah. When he's not right here, so he told me to roll,
so if Verdant right, told
you to roll. He told you to roll, it's on him now. All
right, then it's time to roll.
So.
I'm going to add Verdant.
This is going to hurt a lot. For everyone, I'm going to do two rolls. Just don't panic, okay?
Oh, no.
Nobody panic, okay? Please? Okay.
100 D6.
Why am I smelling like dog in my house?
I don't know.
Well, at least it's not toast.
Yeah, so it smells like wet dog.
The demonic spirit, as it is their turn for the first time, you can see their core heat up. And they do something to where they explode outwards, and you see bits and pieces of souls kind of be shunted from the body, and they pass through everyone over here and anyone who may have been within 20 feet of this in a burst effect.
This isn't a spell?
It's just a burst. Gonna be... On a failed save, you take full damage. On a successful save, you're going to be taking half. I really hope nobody drops to zero hit points. So, here's the first one, okay? So the first one is going to be the fire damage, and then we're going to do necrotic damage, because the fire damage is the explosion, and the necrotic damage is the spirits kind of... going through.
Did we all
bodies.
Pass our saves or no?
Everyone but Verdant.
Okay. Well, that's
the save was 19. So here's the fire damage. Sorry, Verdant. That was on you, buddy. So there's the fire damage. That's the initial attack.
Oh.
That you're taking half of this, by the way. Except for Verdant. And so that's the initial burst outwards from everybody.
So I take half of that and then half that again.
And then here's the necrotic damage.
Oh!
Oh, hey, look at that. Now you're taking half of that in necrotic damage. Except for
25 Verdant. Half is... Do we round up on these or down?
We always round up, so it's 26 on each one.
Yeah.
Well, I know. I get 13 then, okay. Because I'm resistant to fire. I take 51. Oh!
And another 51?
And it was another 51, yes. So the first one was the fire damage, the second was the necrotic damage.
Well,
from the spirits.
getting real fucking comfortable with this area.
Did anybody hopefully it helped a little bit. Zero?
Not currently.
Did my healing help, Isaac?
Yeah, I'm back.
Oh, good.
Started.
You basically took away one of those from him.
Yeah.
You all see around you.
Well, no, I only healed like 20 something.
There was a random bird that was just kind of in the area that you all didn't notice before. When the creature did his burst attack and you all felt these waves of fire and energy from the spirits coming out of it, you all look at that bird and it just turns to ash in the middle of the air from the fire, the hellfire burst that the tree released from itself.
Oh, thank goodness. I'm not... All right, guys, none of us are birds. It does real bad shit to birds.
Oh, shit. All right. Don't turn into a bird.
Thank God Elise was not within the 20-foot radius of the tree.
Yeah, because that probably would have killed me, too.
So Elise is like, oh, frick. I already used my ranged one-time spell. So that's the tree's turn. Back to the top of the order. Red, what would you like to do? You can see that the tree is, like, cooling down. So he probably can't do that move multiple times in a row.
I'm going to all out swing. We gotta bring this thing down.
Okay.
So I'm making my three axe attacks, and because I have my claws out, I get a bonus attack. So I'm swinging four times.
Okay.
26.
26 hits.
Thank you for being wounded.
Is that 23?
23 for that one. Okay. 23 damage.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think 17 doesn't hit regardless.
No, I'm so sorry.
Damn. Exact same rolls.
Uh-huh.
All right. Sorry, that hurt a lot.
Oh, hey! Clap, 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 clap. Let's go!
8, 16, 19, 21.
21 damage?
For that one. Yeah, for that one.
Thank you.
And that's all I got.
Okay. So you all see
and
red.
At the end of my turn, my AC drops by one.
Oh.
Because my shifting is done.
Oh.
It only lasts a minute. We've been fighting for a long time.
Yeah. Elise has already, like, she re-upped your guys' bless. So you have a couple more turns of that. Hopefully you can take the tree down before her bless runs out again. It is Isaac's turn. Isaac. You see Red just going all out, like, next to you and Verdant.
I'm trying to remember, like, when I did my rage.
You were raging when we got into combat last session. So okay, it was probably around the same time Red's did.
So mine'll go down, and I'll use my bonus action to bring it back up again.
Okay.
This is my second rage.
Well, then we'll say this combat. Yeah, we'll start your second rage now, Isaac.
Okay. Which means I still have one turn before Giant's Might goes down then. Because it's always that combo of rage, Giant's Might.
Real quick, at the end of Red's turn, you see the creature do a claw attack at you, Red. Where are my dice? That's why I'm rolling in D&D Beyond. That's right. Okay, hang on. Or Forge. Because he's going to be using a legendary action. And he's going to be using a claw attack. Oh. I'm sure that's probably fine.
No, you had it right. I'm sure that's a problem.
I'm assuming a 22 hits.
Yes.
Okay. So, Red, when you get hit by this claw attack, issues that you have. One,
issue
you
one,
feel
I've
it...
been hit.
Okay, yeah. Fine. Issue one, you got hit.
Issue two, you felt it.
You feel the energy of it is kind of like its blast. So it had the initial slashing damage, plus the spiritual energy around it is also giving you necrotic damage.
Okay.
And you're taking that much.
How much slashing, how much necrotic?
The first one is slashing, and then the second one is necrotic. And that was his legendary action. So sorry, Isaac, your turn. You see it reach out and smack Red a little bit.
Yep, that's about right.
Mm-hmm.
Check my features real quick. I believe I used that already. Yeah, I used that already. Okay. Boop. I would like to swing my axe.
I would love for you to swing your axe.
I would too. Fortunately, game is not letting me.
Do I need to roll for you?
Yes.
Let me open your character sheet again. Hang on. I was
it's
on
just,
burden.
It's just my attacks. Everything else I have.
Your great axe?
Yeah, it's a d20 plus 10. The great axe plus 2, so
yeah,
d20 plus 10.
I already did that. That's what I got in there, buddy.
Sweet, 22.
Yep, so that hits.
All right, cool. Let me grab my... Boop, grab that. And swing. Okay, then...
Bye. 17, got it.
Plus another 7.
Oh, right. You didn't roll everything at once. Okay, got it.
Oh, I separate them. That way you know which one's radiant.
I don't need you to separate them. This guy doesn't care if it's radiant or not.
Okay, I'll fix that for the next round.
All good. No stress, buddy. No stress.
I'll fix it for the next round.
Appreciate you.
All right, DM, can you toss them dice for me?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, 25 hits. Give me your damage.
And bah.
Perfect.
14 for all those.
Oh, maybe you should roll them separately.
Damn.
Where's your plus two? You missed your plus two.
That should be in there. It wasn't the thing.
I don't see it.
All right, so yeah, 16 then.
Okay, got it.
Yeah, for some reason it didn't add it. Okay,
I also feel like you're missing a... Oh, no, you...
Yeah, I'm missing a 1d4. I'm missing the 1d4 because I had two 1d4s. I had two 1d4s.
What's the other 1d4 for?
1d4 is for... the 1d4 is the radiant. So a 1d6 and a 1d4 for radiant. So,
right.
Yeah, so it is 1d4. Yeah.
Yeah, you're good.
So that is correct. All right, cool. Yeah.
You
That's
just missed
all.
Your two. That's fine.
Yep.
Okay, so that was 16. Your two actions, or your one action for two attacks. What else are you going to do? You have a bonus?
No, I use the bonus to re-rage.
Oh, right. Okay, do you want to move?
No, I'm pretty happy where I'm at.
Okay. Abaddon, it's your turn, buddy.
Oh, boy. Just great.
Yeah.
Dude, I don't even know. This sucks.
Just wait.
Man, I know. Like, I don't know, man. I'm like stumped almost. I guess I'll send it to Quebec orbit. Why am I yawning?
I don't know. Why are you yawning?
I don't know. Good question.
Why are you like this?
Because I don't know. Does fire damage even hurt it still? I don't know. Please. Okay, that's going to hit, probably.
We're just tickling it.
Yeah, okay.
You only did 3 damage?
No, that was a bless.
Okay.
I dealt 31 fire damage. 31 fire damage.
Okay.
If I only deal 3 damage at level 12, I would cry. All right, there would be literal tears.
Okay. So, Abaddon, one thing you do notice, when you hit it with your fire attack, it does appear to be mildly resistant to fire.
Son of a gun. I'm going to cry.
What else would you like to do on your turn?
Cry. Who did I give Bardic to? Did you guys use the Bardic I gave you already?
I think they already used it.
Okay. I'm going to look to Verdant and be like, Verdant, please don't pull something like that again. Stay safe. Hold tight. Steadfast. And I'll give him Bardic Inspiration.
Okay. Verdant has Bardic Inspiration.
And that is the end of my turn, madam.
So now it's it is the end of your turn. The demonic spirit is going to be using a second legendary action.
Oh, good.
No, just no.
And you all see him kind of poof out of existence. Ignore the broken bits of tree underneath you. Okay, just ignore the broken bits of tree underneath you, okay? Just, he's not there anymore, okay? Okay?
Uh-huh.
Okay? And then suddenly, you see him appear.
Is this a spell?
This is his ability. He is using something called Shadow Step.
Oh.
Oh, shit, we got teleporting trees.
No,
I don't like this. And you see him turn up over here next to Elise.
No, dude.
Oh, I'm going inside the tree.
But
I think at this rate, we all are.
He can only use a legendary action at the end of someone's turn. He can only use one, so he can't attack her. No, it does say. And then it can make one claw attack. Okay, never mind. He's going to claw attack Elise now. Oh,
by all the realms.
He crit, didn't he?
No. I haven't. Hold on. I found my dice. I haven't rolled yet.
Don't worry, I can stop it, guys. We're fine.
You better, because I can't.
I can try.
Interesting.
Will it hit or no?
Or at least just go, nope!
So you all see the tree. Hang on.
Sorry. Okay. I'm pausing.
So you all see the tree appear next to Elise, and you see one of its spiritual, like, roots reach out to grab her. And somehow he misses her and smashes the ground next to her as he rolls a natural 1.
Good.
So that's the end of his legendary action. So now it's Lisa's turn, and she says, unfortunately, she is now within his fear radius. Yeah.
Oh, no.
So now she has to get rid of, she has to get out of the aura of despair because she is starting her turn in it. So now I need her to roll to see if she can get past the wisdom saving throw. But she has a high wisdom as a cleric. It is a very high possibility that she will probably be okay.
Disengage and run, Elise.
Yeah, sure. Elise got a 24 and is not feared. Elise is going to say no and GTFO.
It's the return of Ultra Instinct Elise.
Okay. It has a 15-foot reach. Where can I put Elise? I mean, I guess she could go over there.
Just away.
Like right here?
Over there?
It's 30.
I gotta get Elise a ring with a spell storing and a Misty Step in there so she could just be like, nah!
Yeah, she'd be 30 away from the tree.
Does she want to be close to you all? I mean, I guess she could. Now that you all aren't in the trees. Well, no, you are still, dang.
We are all still in the tree's threat range. If she moves.
Oh, you're not.
Yeah. Oh, I'm not?
No.
Oh, yeah, you're not.
Huge.
But everyone else is.
Let's go.
She could heal you, though, Abaddon.
Yeah, if she comes close to me, like, not okay. I was going to say I could pull her out of the range, but I guess if she wants to hit the hit.
I'd
be on my turn, though. Yeah, it's on my turn.
You already had your turn. And then it tried to eat her, and then we're not. And then she dodged.
It still has the reaction, so.
Yeah. Yeah, I know.
We gotta get her more escape stuff.
Okay. So he's going to try to hit her when she leaves his threat range. That's her plan.
You know, okay.
It hits.
With a what?
It hits with a 28.
Okay, I'm gonna silver barbs it.
Oh, hang on.
It takes the lower of the rolls.
Yep. So I only got a 16. Elise, what is your... Oh.
Yeah.
Elise's armor not good, is 15.
Eh? Well, dang.
Wait, hang on. Right. Wait. Does she have a reaction? Can she reaction his reaction?
Yes, he can, yeah.
Hang on.
Is she a shield or something?
She has shield of faith.
That's
not it, though. No, I don't think she has that thing that... I don't think she has the thing that the other cleric had.
Can I dive in front of her?
No.
Say, she's only taking half damage from this.
I'm worried about the half damage.
She doesn't have a lot.
I'm giving myself... advantage, by the way, my next attack.
Okay. Hang on, I gotta make it count. I don't have anything I can give her for this, unfortunately.
Dang, so it's gonna hit then, I guess.
Wait.
Holding.
Where is Elise? She's here. Oh, that's too far. If Verdant was closer, he could use Vigilant Guardian, but she's too far.
This, all right. Wait, hold on. Wait is playing with my emotions.
I'm sorry. Okay. So she's going to get whacked once on her way out. Sorry, Elise, honey bee. I tried. So she's going to get whacked once on her way out with his claw attack. All right. Let me get that damage. Hang on. That's low. So that's 13 that you and her will be taking. Okay. So that was her movement. She could still have an action if she desires. Um, She can't mass cure anymore. That's all gone. Abaddon, how bad are you looking?
About a 1/3.
She's running out of heal spells, but she will heal you this.
Damn.
So that uses up her second. Her weapon is still active, which I think I forgot to hit with it last turn. So it's going to move over and it's going to attack. Oh no, I did and I missed. That's right. I swung and I missed. That's right. And so the spiritual weapons... Oh, nope. Wait, hang on. You have to hit first. Never mind. It doesn't hit.
It was 18 and just like, yeah, enough for.
Never mind.
That was so mean.
I know. So that's Elise's turn. She's done. She got whacked on her way out, but she's currently out of its threat range. It is Verdant's turn. I know what Verdant told me to do. But I feel
here's what we're gonna do.
But I feel like he could heal.
He's gonna come in screaming.
He's in the chat. I don't know why he ain't here.
Watching he's probably... Verdant.
I know. I'm just picking on him.
You and Isaac are directly next to him. Surely he could reach out and touch you both and heal you, right? With lay on hands?
It would take an action to heal one person.
Dang it.
Mm-hmm.
I don't paladin enough for this. Hang on. So he could heal one of you.
I don't know if he has any left, does he?
Well, he didn't take any off. He currently has 60. He hasn't used any since you all has had a long rest. Not according to his character sheet.
Okay.
Let's just hope he wasn't mentally keeping track.
I don't recall him healing anyone ever. I only recall him attacking things.
It's a healing. That sounds a whole lot like not smiting.
Yeah, you're right. What do you all prefer? Do you want him to keep attacking or do you want him to heal Red?
You know what? Whatever he would do.
Yeah, whatever he would do.
I don't want to dictate anybody else's characters.
Let's do a higher low chat. Well, I mean characters. I mean players. Higher low
would he notice that we're beat up or
yeah,
would
he would notice. Okay. Abaddon, higher low.
Low.
Okay, he's attacking the tree.
Okay.
Sorry, he's gonna take a step this way because this is where the tree starts, right here. As he jumped a stupid tree, he's like, "Oh, they get Elise. I'm gonna get her one of these days. Gosh dang it." Okay, Verdant. Verdant is going to attack with his halberd. He does have 2 second-level spell slots left that I could pump into his smite.
Kath was the true BBG the whole time.
I am. What are you talking about?
She's like, I could have this big bad guy. Or I could just keep trying to kill Elise.
Gosh dang it. I need you to hit first. Okay, he hits. I keep hitting the damage one accidentally. Okay, so that's his that. And then he gets an extra d6 for that. And then he's going to smite on this first one. And smiting does a lot of damage.
An extra set of d8s, and if this thing's a fiend, he gets some bonus d8.
It is a fiend. So is that 3d8 with his smite?
What level spell is it?
Second level.
It's second level spell slot? Hold on.
I don't see smite on his character sheet. Hang on, I'm sorry. Oh, here it is. Sorry, I found it. It gets so an extra 1d8, so he gets 4d8.
Yeah.
Okay. 48 with his smite, and we're using up a second level spell slot for that. Bam. And he's adding this. Bam, bam, bam. Bam, boom. Okay. Ow. So it's 14 plus the 19. When Verdant hits the tree, you all do notice quite a few of the souls begin to kind of break off from it. And as they start to break off, you can kind of see they begin to like float upwards and then they dissipate. And the tree seems a little bit smaller. Just a little bit. Like it still takes up its square, but you can definitely tell that the tree is shrinking from losing some of the souls as Vernon hits it. Vernon's second attack. AKA we're at half, probably. Second attack from Verdant. Gonna attack. A 19 hits. We're gonna damage. Okay, and then he is going to use his smite again. He has one more second level spell slot that I'm gonna use up for this. So that's, he's out of second level spells now. Oh shoot, the mantle is still up. I should have done that twice. Sorry. There we go. So that was for both turns for his mantle. And when he hits it, you know, at this point, as you all are hitting it, the spirits are kind of like flaking off like bad skin at this point. So he moved, he attacked, he has a bonus action. So we're going to do his bonus action, which is the pole arm, and he's gonna miss. Even with his other stuff, he's not gonna hit it.
Okay. Hit him hard enough, my axe becomes sentient because a soul got in it.
okay, so I think that is everything Verdant can do. It is now the tree's turn again. The tree. Oh, interesting. Oh. Should I use that? That sounds like a lot of fun. I should use that. Yeah, we'll do that one. Hey, Verdant. Isaac, your thing came through.
I'm playing with things. I think I might have found something.
He rolled a 16 to hit the DM, is what that says.
Yeah, what are you doing? Hello?
Don't worry about it. I figured out how to do this.
Okay. So the tree is going to form something with one of his little roots, and it's going to swipe through Verdant's form. And you can kind of see Verdant, like, take a step back. And fortunately, this melee spell attack that he did seems to have missed. But whatever it wasn't good, probably. The name of the attack was called Soul Reaver, but it missed. So we'll just leave that as it is for now.
Soul Reaved.
It is back to the top of the order. Red, what would you like to do?
Say how far I'm gonna move down. We gotta kill this thing. And I'm putting all four attacks into him.
Okay. I guess I'll. I mean, he's still within his square there, so that's probably fine. 26 hits. Arar. Agur. Rarger.
16.
16 damage. Got it. More of those souls kind of flake off as you hit it, Red. 23 hits. Got it. Another bunch of souls kind of flakes off from the back side of it.
18
barely hits, yes. You feel the god redirect your attack again.
Another 18.
Okay, got it.
And my claws.
Your claws are magical, right?
Yes, they are.
Okay. 26 hits.
For another 8.
There we go. It is looking not that good at this point, guys. It is shrinking. You can definitely tell it is losing a lot of its size. And it's getting there. It's getting there. You've almost got it. Isaac,
third phase.
Your turn.
All right, let's try this out here. Boop. And I got a 1d4 for 20. Does 20 hit?
Yes, a 20 does hit.
Okay. And roll. D12 plus 6. It's okay, so it still has a plus 2 on that for my rage. And then boop. 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 Yeah, I think that's what's left after that. So another 9 on top of that.
Okay.
So that's that first attack.
You crush off a couple more spirits from the tree. Somehow. Do you have range? Where are you? Did you move closer to the tree?
Oh, yeah, I would have moved closer. Sorry.
I was like, how are you attacking it from range?
Doing my thing. Hold on. Yeah. 18's not going to hit that. Well, I guess that'll end my turn. 18
hits.
Yeah. It hits.
18's armor class. 18
is its armor class.
All right, cool. So, you know what? I'm just going to do this because... the other part's still messed up. Boop.
Okay, 14.
14 damage.
Got it.
End my turn. For this turn... I will have also Giant's Might down and back up for my bonus action.
You would. Hang on.
Oh, yeah, I mean, that's right. I can grow now.
Can't grow into it. Stop that. There you go.
Thank you.
Okay, so that's what Isaac did for his bonus action, right, Isaac?
Yep.
Okay. It is Abaddon's turn. Abaddon, he's looking unstable.
Okay.
Don't sound defeated. Let's go.
Has it been a minute yet? Or do I stop? Oh, wait. At least I did a turn by me. She's blinded.
She healed you.
Yeah, but she's blinded, though.
I can't help that.
I know. She's your turn by me.
I'm by you. Why am I blinded now?
You're not blinded yet. You weren't within 5 feet of me.
Elise is unhappy. Within 5 feet. She says, Abaddon!
I'm sorry. It's not my fault. I'm sorry.
Turn it off!
I don't know how to. I apologize.
Why are you like
It'll
this?
It'll go away eventually, all right?
Why are you like this? Here. I'm gonna flash everybody real quick. Bam! That's what Abaddon looks like.
I am a beacon. How many more turns do I have this?
Bad enough with five. Verdict.
I think you've got five or something like that, yeah.
Yeah, okay. I have advantage on this next attack roll against it. I'm gonna use my fourth level spell.
Okay.
To do this another traumatic orb.
We absolutely have disadvantage on us because even I can't hit with that light.
Do have advantage, thankfully. So I gotta roll it one more time. And give me a crit, please. Crit. That's a two.
You got part of it. You're just missing the zero.
So it's a 16 is the highest roll. Is that hit?
No.
Not really.
No.
Abaddon's gonna die. Well, freaking!
I'm just waiting for this thing to blow up again.
You know what?
I have my recharge time here.
You know what? Tree, please die faster. You absolutely look horrid.
Are you
casting visual? Yes, I am.
Are
doing
you
this.
Mocking my tree.
I'm mocking your tree.
The wisdom, yeah.
Yeah.
I got an 18.
Frick!
Said no.
Tree says I'm beautiful, and you can't tell me what I do.
Oh God, the tree has confidence.
Oh fuck.
Well, I do nothing on my turn, tree. And I pass.
Confident for the
okay. Damn it. At the end of your turn, Isaac. Uh-huh.
Yes.
Listen, I'm not targeting you, but you are bigger than everyone else.
Swing the branch, Kath!
Please give me a constitution saving throw.
Ooh, I'm decent at those. And I'm also, yeah, within him, so I get a plus two to it. Boop. So plus two to that,
ooh.
So 21.
Okay, so you're only taking half of this. Isaac, the tree, at the end of Abaddon's turn, it kind of looks at you, and you can just feel it breathe in. And while it's kind of breathing in, you feel a piece of yourself going towards it. Like,
me?
No, I'm sorry. Did I say Abaddon? I meant Isaac.
Yeah.
Sorry, Isaac. This is on Isaac. I said Isaac's the target. Sorry.
Yeah, I was like, this is on... I'm like, all right, what's happening then?
It's breathing in a piece of your soul, Isaac.
I don't like that.
You are taking half of this. Have any pluses to that? No. Okay. Aw, what are these ones? Okay, well, you take 10.
Now you know how I feel, Kath. Now you know how I feel.
You take 10 as it siphons some of your life away. Your top hit points go down 10.
All right, I haven't seen my top hit points in a while.
So, that could have been worse. Sad face. It is Elise's turn, because no, Abaddon, you just went, right? Yeah, you went. You missed.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's Elise's turn. She's gonna swing with her weapon, her magical spiritual weapon that she doesn't want to get close to him with. Oh, she hits! Let's go!
Elise said run them pockets.
Okay. Elise does some damage with her spiritual weapon from a distance. She doesn't really want to do anything else. I'm out of third, I'm out of second level spells.
We gotta get her a ring of spell storing.
I have one more first level if she needs to recast Bless, but that's all she's got. So she's just gonna not be in its threat range and try to not aggro it. Actually, no, she should hold. No, she's going to heal herself with her last first level because she is severely wounded. There we go.
Good call.
So now she's completely out of first, second, and third level spells. And her staff of healing is discharged fully. She's tapped 100%. Elise is tapped. This is a problem. That's fine. We're almost done. It's Verdant's turn. Verdant's gonna try to attack it.
Verdant, shotgun!
He's out.
I used all of his stuff. He has one first level. Still. Or did I use that last turn? I think I used that. He has a third level. But he told me not to use it. I shouldn't use it.
Isaac gives him the thumbs up.
He told me not to use the open third level spell, so he is out of shotgun. But we can attack.
Le bonk.
With Bless, that's still not going to hit. Sorry, Vernon. All right, so his first one misses. Oh my god. Second one misses.
I gave him Bardic a while back. Did he use it already?
Oh yeah, you're right. Okay, so that's a
D6. It's a D6, yeah.
Okay, so with Bless and that one. That gives him to a 17.
Why do you roll that on Isaac?
Sorry, I had Isaac clicked. Fuck. It's fine.
Isaac smacks his weapon to the right way.
He still misses, unfortunately, with a 17. Frick. Well, Verdant has a bonus action. He can try to pull our mastery it.
How do you get 11s for every attack?
I'm bad at keeping you alive.
Man rolled a 4, 4, and a 6.
Kath, I think I'm the only one you're allowed to actually drive now.
You shouldn't be absent. I don't roll well. I use the same system you all do when I play you. I don't know what you want
It's like having a kid. All right, take the car. Make sure you don't, mess it up. Put gas in. It comes back. No gas. Car's dented to shit. It still runs.
It's the tree's turn now. That is all Verdant had. So sorry. I'm so sorry. Okay. It is the tree's turn. I don't know what that is supposed to do. I don't know what that trait does. Oh, that's what that does. Okay. Isaac.
Mm-hmm. Come on, Isaac. We know we're throwing hands. I know we're throwing hands. Let's do this. What you got for me?
Isaac, I need you to give me a wisdom saving throw. Yes, you are within Verdant Sphere.
Okie dokie. And 2. It's a 20.
Dang it. Okay. That's fine. So, Isaac. Oops. I didn't mean to throw that. Isaac, the tree you feel is targeting you. Imagine.
That's fine. I'm targeting it.
It looks at you, and you can kind of see in its, spiritual form, all of the faces turn to you. And for one moment, you feel as though they're trying to look inside of you. It's using an attack called Horrific Visage. And you feel that if you didn't push back with Verdant's aura, you would be paralyzed for one full minute and suffer a traumatic mental scar that would permanently reduce your stuff. Thankfully, Verdant was next to you, And as it tries to do this against you, you just feel the warmth of Verdant around you, and you push back the horrific visage, and you are unaffected by its attack.
I yell back at it. Can I have an intimidation back at it?
No. It was a 19 wisdom saving throw.
Hell yeah!
Damn.
I'm never good at these.
And if it had hit, you would have permanently reduced your intel, wisdom, and charisma by 1d4. Permanent.
Which oh. Probably would have been dead. Because without the thing, I do not have a good intel.
Oh no, it's just 1d4. But see, Isaac, if she would have hit me with that and I failed, any amount of wisdom damage gives me dead levels equal to my ranger level.
Yeah.
So that was the tree's whole turn. He tried to visually take down Isaac. Top of the order, Red.
I'm going in. Get the fuck out of my heaven.
19 hits.
For the first one.
20 hits.
Oh, 20 damage.
Oh, sorry, 20 damage? Sorry, I'm used to you doing more than that. Okay, got it.
I don't normally hit that hard, unless it's against my favorites. I just hit a lot.
That's fair.
15 damage?
Yes, 15 damage I take.
18 is armor class.
18 hits.
Throw another 19 on top.
Red.
Yeah.
As you deal the final blow to the creature, you see all of the souls in this chaotic fusion of like spectral and demonic features, the ghostly faces start screaming and swirling around the body. All of the claws and the horns that solidified like the darkness that they were all kind of warped into suddenly just releases, and you see and feel an aura of pure malice just kind of wash over everything, and then peace settles behind it, and you see all of the souls begin to just float upwards, and you see all different kinds of souls in here. Human souls and dwarven souls and animal souls. Everything you can possibly see is currently here. And as you see that, you see Sir Reynard's spirit appearing before you, and he's just kind of looking at you all saying, "Thank you," but he looks a little different, just a little different than what you were expecting. Hang on. I have a thing for this. One second.
We're holding.
Hold on.
Holding.
Wait. Okay. From here, you see that his form kind of solidifies, and he kind of takes on the form of like an older guy with graying hair, and he kind of stands tall above everyone else on here. He seems like much taller, about 12 feet tall, and still in his paladin plate and everything. And he looks at you all and says, "Thank you. Thank you for helping all of these souls. I really do appreciate it. I did have to say, though, I wasn't expecting this outcome with all of you. But it is much appreciated. I can
expect."
That is fair. I feel I owe you the truth before I lead these souls back to where they're supposed to go. I am actually Torm, and I will lead all of these souls to their proper resting places. Thank you again, and I will see all of you, and he points to Verdant, in the afterlife. And he takes all of the souls, and they turn to energy and kind of shoot into the sky. And you all are currently left in a crater with a destroyed tree behind you, and this is all of this. This is what you've got. You are done with the fighting.
Yeah, we still can't get home.
I'm gonna go look in the tree.
Okay.
My light wears off. Please turn me off.
Okay.
I don't wish to be bright anymore.
I'm gonna go over to this guy.
So,
I would like to put a couple heal spells in me if possible.
Sure. Heal yourself up, whatever you desire.
Okay.
His name was Torm, right?
Torm.
Yeah, that's the god of paladins.
Oh.
Of courage and self-sacrifice.
Did not know this.
Yeah.
We were talking a lot of shit to him. That's funny.
I was.
Yeah. I was like, turn to you guys. I fucking told you all he wasn't a spirit, but nobody listens to Red. I'm just crazy Red. God.
Y'all hear that? Sounds like
how many times do I gotta be right before you guys start paying attention to me?
Look, I don't.
No. I want a number. I'm asking for a number because I've lost track of how many times that I was right.
It's okay. You can't count that high.
I'm a trusting person at most, Red, but sometimes I am not.
I figured of all people, you would know not to be just an instantly trusting person.
I'm not. That's why I didn't trust him. And if you said he wasn't a spirit.
Isaac, I'm going to shrink you.
Just saying.
Oh. Elise says, I'm out of heals. Sorry, guys.
I've got one in the tank if one of us goes down.
Elise, I can heal as well, but something. Only if you need to.
We're going to find you something that you can just get the hell away at times.
So while you all are here resting afterwards, Abaddon walks up to the now destroyed tree, and you can see Abaddon in the middle of the tree. There is nothing. There is nothing left inside. It seems that the spirit had actually consumed this being from the inside beforehand. That's why you saw its faces kind of weaving in and out of the bark and everything when you first came to this area. So you're unsure if perhaps the demonic spirit was already controlling it and it just couldn't literally break out of the shell that you all broke for it. So the tree is completely empty. There's nothing here to gather.
Okay.
But what you do see in the middle of the tree appears to be some kind of glowing circle.
They're just giving you a second chance.
Do I recognize this immediately?
Give me an Arcana check.
All right. Do I get advantage on this? No, I don't.
You get advantage.
Okay, well.
Because you've seen it before, if you can remember.
Please go higher than a 5. Thank the goodness.
Abaddon, this looks like one of those circles. It's a little different, but it looks very similar to the one you saw in the sewers.
Oh.
Please. Ladies and gentlemen, I believe we may have a way back. Potentially, I don't know. We have a teleportation circle in the tree.
It's not active.
It's not active though. Son of a gun.
You looked at a lot of the other circles through the books and stuff. Do you recognize it? Maybe you can tell where it's going.
Well, each are slightly different.
We looked through a lot of books, remember?
I have looked through a lot of books, yes. Do I recognize this at all, Kath? Like, through the books that I looked through?
Through all the massive amount of books that Isaac had brought back?
Well, you also remember, Isaac, each one has different runes in each different spot, and it has to connect to a certain thing. Like, it's a lot to memorize.
I know. I'm just hoping you maybe, like, recognize one or two of the runes.
Do I recognize any of it a little bit or no?
Not off the top of your head? Do you have the books with you?
No, we had to dump those for putting a vampire in them.
Oh yeah, wait, we still have him, don't we? Oh no, he's got ripped off, right?
Yeah, my grandpa killed him.
Yeah,
great grandpappy came down here. Do and I know all of us?
Can I? Am I able to activate it, Kath?
You are unsure. Or figure out how to. You will have to spend some time investigating it to see if you can turn it on.
Can I identify it? Figure out a way to turn it on.
Does identify do that? Hang on. Do you have the spell slots for identify?
Yes, I do. It's also ritual cast, which, you know, don't need to use one. Choose an object you must touch with the casting of the spell. If it's a magic item, some other magical imbued object, you learn its properties and how to use them. So do you learn how to use it?
But
it requires attunement.
It's not an object, it's a circle.
Well, it's still a magical circle. I don't know. That's up to you then, I guess.
I know. Hang on. High or low?
High, like my chances of succeeding.
You have a 50% chance.
Represent.
Is it high?
Yeah.
I mean, that's high for our standards.
Honestly. Yeah, a little bit.
Yeah.
Abaddon, you know that your identify will not be able to tell you if this, like, how to turn this on.
Yeah, well, can I spend some time trying to
figure
it out then?
If it's anything like the last one, we know how to turn it on.
Well, if it requires blood, that was the only one that required blood, though, was... Actually, no, both of them did.
Instead, all of them required blood.
Not all, though. Most
don't.
Out of
the three that we've run into, two of them required blood.
Kath, I'll grab my dagger and draw blood, and I'll put it over the portal.
Okay.
Does it do anything?
You don't notice it doing anything right off the bat.
Wait, can I do... That wouldn't do it.
While he's doing that, I'm gonna check out this dude and his axe.
Nope, that doesn't do shite.
Okay.
Can I spend some time to see if I can learn how to activate it, though?
Yeah, sure. Give me an investigation, but this will take you quite some time.
Okay. Can I... Do you want to assist me? Elise, can you assist me with this?
Of course! I would love to, as
since
I can't
we both
do
know
anything
circles.
Else.
All right. So roll twice. Okay, come on. A little better than that, please. That's great.
So that's that for now. So Isaac, you go up to the guy with the axe and everything. From what you can kind of tell, the corpse has been here for quite some time. You can't tell how long, because, I mean, this is a spiritual world, so it's unsure exactly how this is even here, as this is an afterlife. But from what you can gather, what probably happened was, because you can see, like, one of his legs has been crushed. When he went to kind of swing at the tree, it probably awakened it and then killed him. Because you can see his arm's been ripped off and his leg's been crushed. That's probably what happened.
All right. I would like to remove the axe and check him over.
Check him over for what?
I want to look at his armor, see if he had any other things on him of use. And...
You can take the axe. It is very old and rusty. The armor and everything is also rusty. It is really old. He doesn't seem to have anything of value upon him.
Ooh, good things then. I'm going to take the axe and put it aside. And I'm going to look at the armor, and I want to see if I can date some of the craftsman techniques.
Okay.
I'm going to heal at least for 15, by the way, before I reinvestigate it.
Okay. Isaac.
Yes.
I think that's a history check for you, buddy.
Okay.
This armor is, it appears to be elvish made. You're not familiar with a lot of the intricacies on it, but you do notice that one of them is of an older design. Guesstimating, you could probably put this maybe 2,000 to 3,000 years ago, maybe, unless he just found the armor and put it on from like something old, right? So.
I'm going to find the most ornate thing on there, most detailed ornate thing that he has on his armor.
All he's got is his breastplate left.
Okay, so he doesn't have the shoulder pads or anything or a helmet?
They're like rusted to crap. You can't really see anything on them.
Okay. What he's looking for is a spot that he can study the details of later on to take with him without really disturbing the body. He's actually going to move the body probably over here and bury it with his shovel. Lay it to rest.
So wait, you don't want to mess with the body, but you want to mess with the body? I'm confused.
I mean, I don't want to take like the armor and destroy the body altogether. He wants to just pick the body up and move it to a hole.
Okay.
He's trying to be gentle, but he wants a piece of that old ass armor so he can look at the way it was made.
There's not really any way that you can do that unless you have, like, a cutting metal tool.
Whips out all his tool.
Do you have something that cuts through metal?
I have smithing tools. I have all kinds of crap here. Would you like the list of my items that I have?
Which tools do you have?
All right, 1 second. Loop, backpack, holding. All right. I have glass blower's tools, jeweler's tools, leatherworking tool, mason's tools, smithing tools.
Down. Hold up. Was the first one was glass?
Yeah, I've still got some glass blower tools.
Next.
All right. I have jeweler's tools.
Jeweler's tools? No, they wouldn't have it.
Leatherworkers?
No, leatherworkers wouldn't have anything for metal.
I have mason's tools.
Mason's tools for stone? I don't think they'd have scissors to cut the metal, no.
Smithing tools. And I have some wood carver's tools as well.
Wood carvers wouldn't have scissors to cut the metal. Smithing tools. You could probably use the forceps and, like, wiggle it back and forth and snap it off, but it would be leaving quite a large dent in the armor to do so. It's your choice.
I would rather be respectful than anything. So instead, I'm going to go over and I'm going to take my shovel out, build him a proper grave. And then I will place him in the grave and bury him. I've got his axe, and if it's anything close to what the armor is, I'll have more time to look through that detail.
Okie dokie. Sounds good. So you have the axe, and the axe does appear to have some of the same designs on it, but the axe itself seems maybe between like the 1500 to 2000 range instead. So the axe is younger, quote unquote.
Yeah, he probably had to redo the handle or something.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, he's got that in his bag, and yeah, he will bury him while everybody else figures out what's going on.
Okay. I can do that. Hang on. I have a thing for that. Hang on. Can I match the ground? Let me see. That's not the same color, but we can work with that. There you go. Where do you want it? Like there?
Yeah, like right there.
Okay. There you go. You have buried a dude that was under the tree.
A wild time. It's not the first time I've done this.
Yeah.
At least, do you want to... You think you'd be up to maybe giving some last rites to this poor fellow?
She says, sure. And she will give them some last rites per your request. And then she'll go back to helping Abaddon. So you now have buried the dude. I can't physically move it because it's part of the image, but just pretend he's no longer there.
Yeah.
Red, how are you feeling while everyone else is doing this?
Tired. Kind of hungry. So, like, everybody else is doing something, kind of look around, like, man, there's... I killed it. I want a trophy. And I'm looking at the tree. I'm like, I really can't take anything. There's nothing left to take.
Red, you got... I hear you over there. You have a trophy.
Yeah, but that's from the last one. I want one from this one.
Oh, okay.
This one was bigger. And since, you know, this wood is, you know, destroyed, there's really nothing I can do with it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to go, like, to the trunk, like, over here.
Sure.
And I'm going to take my, some of my tools, and I'm going to carve symbol Malor into it, and that Gav Redson was here.
Okay.
You hear Isaac around the tree rattling his wood carver tools.
Quit your rattling, I'm working over here.
Would you like to borrow them?
Sure.
They'll hand Red his woodcarver tools.
Dang. Are we figuring anything out, Cass, yet?
With your first investigation, no. You feel like you were close, and Elise was pointing out some numbers. Okay. But you feel like you need a little more time. Give me another investigation. So that was about an hour, and you're going to do another hour now.
It's better.
It's worse.
No, the first one's better.
Yeah, because you're rolling at advantage. That's fine.
Yeah.
So Abaddon and Elise have been at this for like 2 hours. Obviously, Red, that doesn't take you terribly long. Isaac, you do bury the body in those 2 hours. And Verdant is kind of contemplating life as he does.
Looking at the clouds.
No, he's looking at the tree. He helped. Gosh dang it. While Elise and Abaddon are doing that, anyone else want to do anything else? As the time is progressing, you do feel the air in this area getting better. Before, it just kind of felt very stale, very, like, angry, and you can just feel that this area is once again back to being peaceful as much as you can be in the deep wilds.
Has it reached that time period that I usually send Melody a message?
No, that would have been earlier. So
it hasn't been a day since?
Not since you've done it last time, no. Because you all woke up and then came to the tree, and then you fought the tree, and now you're at the tree.
Okay, so I'm trying to get an idea, like, how much longer do I think it would be before it's time for me to send?
You're really not sure. Time here doesn't seem to be moving. Like, there's no rain. You're not sure. Like, if time here is passing the same as your world, you don't feel tired yet, and you always send it right around when you're sleeping. I mean, other than extremely wounded, that doesn't count as tired.
Yeah. That's a different kind of tired.
Right.
All right. When Red's done with his thing, I'll collect my wood carving tools from him.
Okay.
I just want credit.
And...
Obviously, no one's blessed anymore.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I still feel blessed, Kath.
You should, because her god helped you all hit stuff.
Yeah. Did, in between me investigating, if I look at my book, did the Walla city thing, or was it still empty?
All of everything you've written is still standing there.
Okay, that's great.
Sorry.
Is there any wood long enough for me to make an axe handle for that axe that I just got?
Not out of this wood. This is all broken and dead.
Are the trees over here normal looking trees, or are they different kind of trees?
Everything in this area has been consumed. There is no more life in anything here. So, like,
yep, everything's dead.
You here. Have to go back to the not dead deep woods to get anything.
Ugh. All right. I guess I'll just wait for the rest of wait for Abaddon to figure out his studies.
Okay.
You know, I'm intelligent. I'll go help him.
Okay. Sure.
He doesn't know magic that well, so he's just pointing out things that he might know from his runes.
Sure. I mean, whatever you guys think is best, you know?
That one looks like it's upside down.
So, at the end of your 2-hour stint, Abaddon, you think you can activate it. What it needs is it seems to need an extremely high-level spell kind of poured into it as an energy source to turn it on temporarily.
Can I tell what level?
Probably at least a 3.
I have a 3. A 4, technically.
Mm-hmm. And it'll turn on temporarily. You don't know how long temporarily is. It could be a turn, it could be a couple turns. You're not sure. So it would probably be like a gather everybody and go kind of thing.
Okay. Well.
Yes.
So you said it took them a couple hours and my thing didn't take me long?
Nope.
Could I take a short rest?
Sure.
Yeah.
That's why I was asking.
The whole time, could I be singing? Oh, wait, do I have that thing yet? Can I do that?
I don't
have it yet. Never mind. There's like the what are my features? No, I think I have it. Yeah. I'm gonna do a song of rest, and I'm gonna kind of whisper and stuff like that, so that Red, you heal an extra 1d6 hit points on it.
Let's go. Hey, I'll take.
Let's
go. You know what? I'm gonna spend. Yeah, I'm spending some more hit die. That did not get me very high, actually.
Represent.
So, that's what you know, Abaddon. At the end of the 2 hours.
Alright, everybody. So, I don't know where this goes. But we can... We can always test it and hope it goes back home. I know how to turn it on temporarily.
If you need so a test subject, I'll go.
Well, it requires a high-level spell slot, and I have, like, 2 left. And again, we can't really communicate exactly where you go.
Well, that sounds like...
Sounds like we're all going or none of us are going.
Exactly.
Fuck it, I'm in. Let's do this.
I do not want to be here, and if it brings us somewhere better than here, I will take that chance.
This place isn't bad.
It's not bad, but there's a lot of big things here that really like to hurt us.
As long as we don't land back at that fucking fortress, I believe we'll be all right.
I hope not. Well, everybody get by and near, and I'll activate it, and we'll jump on it immediately.
All right, let's go. Elise raises her finger. She says,
Yes?
Do we want to, like, rest before we go in case we show up somewhere not mildly safe?
Fairness, I guess. Have we ever been safe?
Yes, we could.
Know. I'm just saying, you know. We don't have to.
If we were going to rest, here would probably be the best place because there's no life here.
We could do that real fast then, yes, and then...
Yeah, so...
Go at it in a bit. All right,
let's set up camp.
I'm just going to leg against the tree and sleep there.
For 8 hours?
Yep.
Okay.
I'm not moving.
He's pulling Isaac.
I just pulled my blanket, that's it. My bedroll. Wrap it around me.
Yeah, I'm not even going to set a... I'm not going to set up a tent either. If there's no weather going on, Isaac's not setting up a tent either. He's just going to lean up against the tree as well.
Yeah, you don't see any, like, it's not raining, but you don't remember, like, any of the rain and stuff that was going on from before, so.
Just kind of stopped.
Yeah, from what you can tell.
All right, let's set up a fire so we can ward off anything really kind of, any animals coming around.
Say, about, from about an hour away, we stopped seeing wildlife.
All right, let's rest up then. I'll take first watch.
Okay.
I'll also take first.
Elise, you want to use my bedroll as a pillow?
No, I'm okay. I can. Who's? Are we just sleeping and praying nothing comes over here? Or?
Pretty much.
I mean, we're taking stay watch.
Up. Yeah, we're taking watch.
Okay.
I mean, either way, something's going to attack you if you're in a tent or not.
I mean, that's fair.
I mean, remember Marco? He got attacked by a got attacked by a hand, if I remember right.
No, that was her.
Yeah, that was.
I thought it was Marco that got attacked.
No, it was me again.
We're definitely going to find something for you to escape with.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So who's taking first watch?
I am.
Okay. And everyone else is going to sleep?
Yeah.
Red said he's going to be up too. Not sure.
Yeah, I'll take one with Isaac.
So Isaac, you and Red are awake. Everyone else is like trying to take a quick long rest, quote unquote, quick long rest. So, Red, you and Isaac are awake. And you're still hungry, Red.
Yeah.
And you know there's not going to be any food for miles.
Yeah, I know. And you still got some like, grilled dinosaur?
Well, I wasn't grilled. I had the raw steaks. You know, if you want to start a fire over there and set up a couple steaks.
Yeah,
I think I got some butter still.
We'll cover it in butter, cook it over a fire. That's everybody like gets a kebab. Meat. We're making kebabs. That's what we're doing.
Oh, hold on, let me get my kebab sticks out. Just everybody's sleeping, and when they wake up, they just hand them kebabs.
Kebab.
I think I still have a little bit of frozen vegetables, so I'll chop them up, add them to the kebabs.
Yeah.
I'll make sure Verdens has mushrooms.
Why?
He's got to eat his veggies.
I hate mushrooms, too. If you ever feed me mushrooms, I will rage quit.
First off, I am a good cook. I usually don't do that for anybody else. I take food allergies and food dislikes into consideration.
Unless it's for
Isaac, on the other hand, says eat your veggies.
Okay, there's a fire.
Mushrooms aren't veggies, Isaac.
Technically a fungus, but
unless you want this.
Yeah, it's not a veggie.
Eat your funguses, Verdant.
Which one do you want? That one's bigger.
We'll do a smaller fire.
Okay.
Personal cooking fire. One that's in the ground so it doesn't show.
Yeah, I'm gonna dig a fire hole.
Okay, just pretend this is in the ground then. There's a dark hole.
Cass, like, why do you all have to make this difficult?
You're putting the survival guy into a survival situation.
It's fine.
Having things done.
It's fine. I gave you your fire. That's darker, so it's in the ground. Just imagine.
Hold on. I'm back over here. I'm not going to just walk off and leave everybody.
They're fine. They're cuddled up into the roots of the dead tree.
I'm letting Red cook. I gave him a couple steaks to chop up and do whatever he wanted with. And I gave him a skillet.
You're letting Red cook? Okay. Hey, Red, you're cooking.
Yeah, I don't understand.
I'm just saying you're cooking. God saying you're cooking. How are you cooking it? That's all I'm saying.
Well, he gave me butter, a skillet, and some skewers. So what I'm doing is I'm just cooking everything in the skillets while they're skewered.
Okay.
Cover it in butter, fry it.
Cool.
I don't have any seasonings.
Maybe you could just go to Abaddon and me for more seasonings.
He's sleeping. That's not worried about it. He'd be fine like this.
I bet that still tastes good. Damn it, I want a steak now.
All right, Red, you cook your food. You have a couple skewers there. Quite a few skewers, actually.
Make sure everybody has enough to have plenty.
Isaac's over there I should have given him some garlic.
There you go.
Oh, thank you.
It tastes
pretty
good. I'll
eat a few and have the other ones bundled up so when they wake up, they get some.
I should have gave you some garlic.
Yeah.
It's good, though.
Yeah, I'm just going to spend the watch meditating over a fresh kill.
Yeah. For sure. Isaac, is there anything you want to do during your first watch?
While he's doing watch, he's thumbing over the axe that he got. He's studying, what he thinks the wood is, some of the techniques he can use to remove the rust without damaging, engraving or anything like that.
Mm-hmm.
He fully plans to restore this.
Okay. Sure. You tell me how you're going to do that and we'll make it a thing.
It's going to be the restoration period will probably be back in town.
Yeah, yeah.
But, yeah, honestly, he's not even going to do disassembly at the moment. He's going to, right now, he's just studying it, seeing if they're at the bottom part of the handle's wrapped with a leather, what kind of leather is it?
Mm-hmm.
Or what leather he thinks it is, some of the twine, what he thinks it is. Okay, they put this kind of edge on this.
There's no twine on the axe.
Okay. See, that's why he's trying to figure out, if there is twine, what did they... If they put a leather handle on the end of it, did they... What they did with it.
Ah.
This is full examination without disassembly at the moment.
Okay. Sure. You're researching the axe.
Yes.
Nothing happens during your shift. You don't hear anything other than, the breaking of trees that are obviously dead and just decaying somewhere nearby. But nothing comes by. Nothing passes by.
Don't and I feel any ends. Weird things?
Nope.
Cool. Shit. Nobody said one was going to take number two. We don't have Raynard for a next person. Damn it, should have brought Marco. He's doing important shit.
Raynard? Who's Raynard?
Sir Raynard?
I know us. I was kidding.
He leaves. Isaac finally remembers what his name is. I'm trying to figure. Red, who do you think Elise should babysit?
Let's just have Verdant take the middle watch.
Okay.
And then he'll wake up about on Elise.
Solid call. All right. He'll wake up Verdant, put a skewer in his hand.
Where is this food?
Your turn for watch.
Oh, is it? Okay.
All right. Next person you'll be, next people you're adding will be Abaddon and Elise.
Okay. I got it.
Three, four arrow traps set up.
Okay.
They're there for 8 hours.
Yep. Okay. So you and Isaac cuddle up and get some rest.
Isaac tells him before he lays down, he goes, you know, I still have that stone.
Mm-hmm. What stone?
Oh, the one that's an alarm.
Oh, How long have you had that?
Ever since you told me to put away.
And I'm going to sleep. I'm too tired to be angry right now. You might as well set the alarm.
All right, I will set the alarm, whitelisting all of my friends.
Isaac, do you remember the issue with that alarm stone? Do you remember?
I don't think he does, but I do.
Red, do you want to tell what happens when he sets it up?
Yeah, Isaac, it's a faulty one. So once it goes off, it doesn't stop going off.
So yeah, it doesn't stop going off until it hears you, which you have to outshout it.
Yes. So do you pull it out and is it still going?
Because it's been in the bag of holding? It's still going because you never were able to turn it off before.
Okay, so if that's the case of what's going in, Isaac grabs it hand in bag, starts to pull it, starts hearing it, goes, oh, nope, and pushes it back down in the back of holding.
Everyone's never like, no,
never mind, I'm going to use that later for something.
You were never able to turn it off. Because you can't shout louder than it screams.
I have an idea. Give me, you got some.
Maybe stick your head in the bag of holding, let you yell at it?
No. Just hear me out. I'll grab some rope. I'll tie it around the stone.
Uh-huh.
Get it nice and secure. And I'm tying it to one of my arrows.
No.
What? Why?
You're not shooting my stone away.
No. One of the arrow traps.
Oh, so if it goes off, it rips it out of the bag? If it goes off,
it rips it out of the bag, wakes us all up, and maybe gets stuck into someone and that's screaming at them.
You know what? It's fine. Isaac will put his hands in there, tie it around the thing, and he's just letting the rope come out of the bag, and he's holding the bag. So if his arrow trap goes off, it'll rip the stone out of the bag.
Okay. That's fine to me. All right, Red Isaac, you go to sleep.
Yep.
It's Verdant's turn. Well, since you all don't know what's happening to Verdant, he has his watch. And then he wakes you up, Abaddon, you and Elise. Abaddon, you and Elise get a long rest, as you all were able the ones to sleep first. Congratulations.
Yippee. Okay.
You both have your spells back. And Elise is like, yay, I can feel energy again.
Oh. Yeah.
I can heal. I can fight.
Okay. My book's still empty?
Well, yeah. No, it still hasn't moved. Your words are still there.
Okay, well. I hope this thing brings us back home.
Gosh, I do hope so. What if it takes us to, like, somewhere else in the world?
Then I guess we will figure it out. I have the rune of I have the teleportation circle written down from, you know, the main spark base. So if we find a mage who can do that, if we do end up somewhere else, we can get his services.
Okay. I mean, it. As long as it gets us out of this plane and at least back onto the material plane, surely we'll be able to get back home, right?
Hopefully, yes.
How you feeling, Abaddon? How's your dude?
I honestly don't know how I'm feeling. It's just been kind of flow into getting through this and then deal with it at the end, you know?
I mean, we have lots of cool stuff waiting for us back home, right?
Sure, yeah.
What do you mean, sure, yeah?
I'm conflicted, you know?
Yeah.
Like, I don't know still if my brother's actually alive. I don't know what that means for me or my family. I don't know what... I don't know. And honestly, I'm quite terrified. I'm worried for him and for everybody, really. Because we still don't know if they're there or not. We were told that there were people that arrived. We don't know if those were the ones we saved from the Shadow Realm or the ones we saved that we brought back from the keep. We don't know. We were just told it was people. It could still all be a fever dream.
And what if he is real?
I guess we'll cross that bridge when we get there.
You don't want to, like, hope?
What? I don't know. I've held this guilt over my head for so many years. The fact that I killed him, I was the one to do so. I was the one who ruined everything, who tore down a lot in my village. Only to learn that he might actually not be dead. Kind of... I don't know.
I mean... He probably was dead for a time, and maybe they just brought his soul back.
I guess that is a possibility. In a world of magic, anything can happen, I guess.
I don't remember much about anything, because you all told me what happened, so... I hope that they're there whenever we do get back, and I hope we all still have jobs when we get back.
We'll see what timeline and what everything happens has passed. Because what I know between planes, usually time is weird. So hopefully it is not. I know the Feywild is the worst for that. I don't know about any higher planes. Like this one.
Sorry. Yeah.
I'm just trying to live, I guess, at the moment and not feel.
She, like, takes a finger and pushes your shoulder a little bit.
I stop looking down and just look towards you, yeah.
You gotta feel stuff to experience stuff, you know?
You're right.
Pushing all of your stuff down is not healthy.
Yeah. Sometimes it seems like the easy option. But I know it's not great, and I'm trying not to. But in this situation, I didn't know how else to react with everything going on. Also, other side of me, is doing its things.
I mean, you're getting closer to fixing that, right?
I hope so, yes. Still don't know what it lies near the side of that door. But something does.
Yeah. I'm excited. I think you're gonna do fantastic things once we get rid of the bad things.
I'm excited yet also terrified at the thought. You know? Like, I've had so many opportunities before to get rid of it. It happened once. And then I wanted it back. Because I was scared. You know?
Mm-hmm.
And then it's like a love-hate relationship, you know?
Yeah.
Like a toxic person in your life that you want out, yet you feel like you can help them, but you know you really can't.
She glances at Red, looks back at you. Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
What am I toxic for?
I see what she looks at. Do I see that she glances over? I think Red's a different case in this scenario.
I'm just still flabbergasted at the one time when he tortured those people. You know?
Yeah. Like, I
didn't.
Yeah.
Hold on, I never tortured anyone. What?
You are asleep.
Oh my god. I didn't do anything.
Yes, you did. The cultists.
Just read it in his sleep.
The burning people.
I know who she's referring to, but I didn't hurt any of them to get information.
You burned them alive.
No, I didn't. That's a you thing, sir.
I never mind.
Maybe her and Abaddon are remembering it wrong, then.
Oh. Also, I know he's not moving on from me for a moment. I know Red's not the most brightest person in the world. Have you?
He's a cutie pie. How dare you?
I wasn't being mean. I was going somewhere with that thought.
She gives you a look.
I'm sorry. But, and I know we all assume it. Do you like Red a lot?
She freezes. Why do you want to know?
I just want to help.
I don't need help. I'm a strong, independent Elise.
Then would you tell him then?
She doesn't. No, <that's> wrong. I don't know. He's been acting weird ever since I got back, so I don't know. What happened? He won't tell me.
Do I know?
I don't know. Do you know?
I think.
Yeah.
Yeah, you told me, yeah.
Yeah, you know why I'm acting weird.
Yeah. It's not my place to say. I know why. He is. But.
She glares at you.
It's on him.
So you know.
I do know, yes.
So you know.
Why are you giving me that look? Don't stop that.
Abaddon, what have I done for you? I've done a lot for you, haven't I?
You have healed me a lot, yes.
I've also done other stuff for you. We've worked together. We've done stuff together in the group.
Yes, we have.
We hang out together. I feel like you might owe me.
I owe you now.
Call it a favor. Just call it a favor.
You have brought me back from the brink of death a few times, yes.
Do you want her to roll persuasion?
Kinda, yeah.
Okay. No, that's okay. I just want to know if you would be willing to allow her to roll persuasion. 100%. Okay.
100%.
Ooh.
Oh, Elise is persuading you to tell her. She's like, I feel you should tell me so that I don't get blindsided when we get back to our plane. Please.
You do have a point there. All right. But if it does come up, you cannot say I was the one who told you. All right?
Okay. I don't know nothing. Okay.
Okay. So... In the other realm, the one that we told you about the story, found my brother, whatever, all the people. Red had somebody he knew there also. And apparently, I think it was like his first crush or something like that. A first love that he had that was there also. And so now we believe she's back, if all those people are actually back.
Uh-huh.
And with my brother. So that's why I think he's acting weird and conflicted.
I see.
Because I believe he is interested in you. He just doesn't know how to show it sometimes. But then there's also that fact now. So I think he's kind of torn. And is uncertain maybe what to do. Because, I mean, it's like if you had like somebody, you know, if let's say Lawala, for example, in my situation, left. And then all of a sudden I started liking somebody else. And then all of a sudden she returned out of thin air. It's kind of like you'd have to be put between a rock and a hard place of, oh crap, the person I loved is back now, and then there's this other person. So I think that's why he is like that.
I just want you to know really quick that I confused myself while you were explaining that, and I imagined Kasula, not Lawala, and I was very confused for like a second. This is her saying that. She was like, I understand.
Yeah, that's not, I know I've mixed it up before at the start because I have like a lot of things on my mind and Kasula did terrify me for a minute. Uh-huh. So it was like, I mean, Lawala did too because she wears the pants sometimes and it scares me.
Girls, don't good take at that.
Yes, very much so. But no, it's fine, yeah. So again, I get it. So I don't know where he's at, but that's that. But I do think that he does care for you a lot. And I know he does not take hints very well. And so I believe it would maybe be best if you did tell him.
Would you go back to Lawala?
I would, maybe. I 100% would, actually. In my case, I love her very dearly. Huh. And it took me a long time to find love anyways. But I don't know about Red's situation. I think they were... From what I know, they were like friends, good friends, and then maybe lovers or crush. I don't know the full story. Red, did you tell us the full story out of Game Real Fast?
So I have.
So I can't remember. I'm blanking.
Yeah, I told you guys. She was my first love, and like kind of taught me like what love actually was.
Okay.
And I told you the reason why I'm conflicted is because, for me, it's been like 9 years.
Gotcha.
It's been a few months for her.
Right.
So I'm still fresh on her mind.
Yeah, I relay that to her now that I remember it properly. So that is why.
I see. Mm-hmm. She looks very conflicted.
Can I try to... Very sneakily.
You want to insight her?
I want to cast detect thoughts.
Really?
I'll get her surface thoughts, yes. And then if I want to poke deeper, she has to make a save.
Wow. Well, you're right next to her. It's very quiet.
Can I try to cover it up with like a cough?
Romeo deception. So
all right, I'm good at these. 25.
Okay. Hang on. I'm going to give her advantage because you are. That's fair. Right,
we are
right
next to
each other.
Yeah. I'll go take a sip of water and pretend like I'm choking on it like I do all the time.
Uh-huh.
And then I'm going to just try to cast it.
I don't know, Kat. That's pretty accurate.
Ooh. I won.
That was pretty close.
That was, yeah, it was pretty close.
She looks at you and she's like, yeah, he chokes on water. That checks out.
Yeah.
He does that.
And so and I'll just kind of look at her and like be like, so, you know, what are your thoughts on that? Like, will you tell him? Do you want to tell him? What are your thoughts? And then I'll read her thoughts, like her surface thoughts.
Okay. What are Elise's surface thoughts right now? She is angry. And she says, why the frick didn't he tell me in a not nice way? Why didn't he tell me about this beforehand? Why is he keeping this from me? Why haven't we talked about this yet? If we're a thing, he should talk to me about this. But he hasn't talked to me about this yet. Was he just going to show up there and then she's going to be there and then it's just going to be a thing at that time? Is he really just going to let that happen?
Can I...
Abaddon's staring at me. Why is he staring at me? Like, are you okay?
I'm all right. You stand up for a second.
No.
I have something I want to... I want to show you something. It's cool.
No. Why are you being weird?
Okay.
Is it because I made you tell me?
No. I'm just thinking. I'm processing. There's a lot going on in my head all the time.
Uh-huh. She's her surface thoughts are now, he's acting weird. Why is he acting weird? What's he doing? Is he doing something sussy? He's doing something sussy, isn't he? That's her surface thoughts right now. She hasn't caught you.
I'm aware.
She's suspicious.
Mm-hmm. Again, I don't know what Red is. I don't know where he lies on what side of the fence.
Uh-huh.
In all honesty, I'm rooting for you.
Uh-huh.
I am. You know?
I believe you.
It's been kind of funny, honestly, seeing you try and him not see the flirting sometimes. It's quite funny.
I've never flirted a day in my life. How dare you?
You sure?
Don't you raise your voice at me in an exclamation.
Do I hear in her head if she's lying? The surface thoughts a little bit?
Surface thoughts are, yeah, I've been trying to, but he doesn't notice anything.
Can I go and try to hug Elise?
You can. And she'll give your back a pat, and she'll be like, he's acting super weird. Maybe that's just his normal state of being.
I'll just look at her and be like, it'll be all right. I said, don't be mad at him. He's not the smartest person on the earth, remember?
We're not on
he
earth.
Is smart. Smartest person on this plane currently.
How do you know? There were monkeys back there. Didn't he try to get married to one of the monkeys?
I don't know. Anyways, he's Red. I believe in you. You've got this, all right? Just keep at it. I believe.
Thank you.
He's Red. I believe in you.
Did you give me inspiration? That's what you usually say when you give people inspiration.
I don't give inspiration, no.
Oh,
sorry.
I'm so sad.
I mean, the words are inspiring, though, no?
Yeah, no.
There you go.
How long does detect thoughts last?
1 minute.
Okay.
So before it ends, I do want to ask one more time, like, so are you going to ask him or tell him that you like him properly and not like blandly because he needs it blandly?
I don't know.
And then I'm going to try to push further into her thoughts to get deeper thoughts.
Oh, you're
going to
make her roll now. Is that
yeah.
what we're doing?
Yeah. Wisdom 18. I know she's got high wisdom.
But she's the wisdom girl.
I know she's the wisdom girl and I'm hoping she rolls low. I could also silver barbs it because that'd be really funny. She fails. I see her eyes get deeper.
But
now
she
knows. Now she, I think she knows. Hold on.
Abaddon, you
if you probe deeper, the target must agree with
so...
If it fails, you get insight on its reasoning, if any, its emotional state, and something that looms large in its mind, so there's something it worries over, loves, or hates. If it succeeds, the spell ends. So I succeeded now. Either way, the target knows that you are probing in its mind, and unless you shift the attention of the creature's thought, the creature can use this action on its turn to make an intelligence check. Whatever, it's ended, so. Yeah, it knows now.
it knows.
She knows now. I'm sorry. I'm reading. I was reading the thing, and I'm blah blah blah.
Okay, so you delve.
I learned
deeper.
The deep thoughts first. Yes, and then she realizes.
Okay.
So I asked him, like, are you gonna tell him? How do you feel? Like, you gotta be blunt.
She doesn't know if she wants to tell him or not, due to the fact that he has another love back home now, and she doesn't know how that's gonna go. So she doesn't know what to do about that. Yes, she likes him a lot. Love, she doesn't know because he hasn't reciprocated anything, but he did give her a ring, so she thinks that he did love her, but now she doesn't know. Because now she's extremely conflicted about this information that you have told her.
Gotcha.
And then she slaps you and screams at you.
I'm sorry.
Waking
I'm sorry.
Everyone up in camp.
I'm sorry. Okay.
Let me fight.
Ow.
How
much damage do I take, Kath?
I let the tail comes out.
No, you're fine. It's fine. Right?
You take one bludgeoning to your face.
Ow. We're fine. We're fine. Go back to nobody. Go back to bed. Elise getting mad at me. Just go back to bed, please.
What did you do?
For nothing. Yet. Mostly.
This bitch just tried to read my mind with a spell.
Successfully, might I add.
I just kind of like. Eyes like
she slaps
when
you
close.
Again.
I
kinda...
shield myself from that when I said, stop it. I should have stopped it.
Isaac, Elise said, bitch. She doesn't cuss. I think.
I'm so proud of you, Elise.
I think Abaddon fucked up.
Oh, yeah. The fuck are you reading her mind for?
Ugh. Hey, Abaddon.
She slapped Elise you a second time, by the way. You got hit a second time. You take another unarmed strike damage to the face.
Okay. Ow.
I was gonna say hit him again, but you got it.
I mean, I gotta. What are you trying to learn from her? Because this might require me holding you.
Elise is an open book. All you gotta do is just ask her. She's always been a straight shooter with us. You don't gotta do that.
She's looking at you angrily. She's looking at you super angrily.
Okay,
and with
I was gonna give her a look.
She's
I was
trying
not...
to tell you to shut the frick up. Her eyes are telling you to shut up.
What'd you even ask? Like,
yeah, what are you asking about? What's going? Let's talk it out.
Did you two eat? There's kebabs over here.
I didn't. I'm very hungry, says Elise. Aren't you hungry, Abaddon? Maybe that's why we're having this tat. We're hungry, aren't we, Abaddon?
Sometimes your mood can be influenced by nutritional.
Yes,
deficits.
We didn't.
Make sure you get all the food you got. We got root vegetables mm-hmm. and meat.
Did he say something insensitive, Elise?
No.
Go back to sleep. It's fine. I can handle it.
All right. If you need me to chop off his ankle or something, wake me up.
Okay. They go back to sleep, and she waits a second, and then she looks at you and raises her hand again in a threatening manner. Go get the kebabs.
Okay. I'll go get
the kebabs. You go get them and bring them back, and she eats.
I'll just point to her, and I'll cast a message in her head. And I'll say, that was a little rude. But also, I think you should tell him. Also, my face really hurts now. That sucked.
She replies, good. I'll think about it. Eat your dang kebabs.
I eat my kebab.
Okay. The rest of your shift goes without too much issue. And it is now time for everyone to wake up, so everyone can now click the long rest button.
I will tell her what I heard, by the way.
And do you want to get slapped again? Because telling her is going to make her slap you again.
I'll just say confidently, maybe I don't like it this time.
Get her with the kink. Damn.
High or low, Abaddon? Does she care about that?
I rolled a deception. So if you're on a roll of insight, you can, I guess. I feel like this is a worthwhile roll. I'm trying to act all like coy now. No, I don't want to be hit again.
She slaps you again.
Oh!
Don't freaking lie to me, Abaddon.
That was the one time. I'm sorry, okay?
Second time, technically.
I owe you one now again, all right? This is definitely a big favor.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Apologies. I felt like it was good to know. I'm on your side. I really am.
Okay? You hear her crack her knuckles. Mm-hmm.
She fucked up three gnolls, man. She could take your ass.
So these kebabs are really good.
Yeah, they are, aren't they?
So delicious. Hey, look at that. It's time to wake everybody up.
It is time to wake everybody up.
Wow. I wake everybody up.
Save me.
All right, everybody, wake up. It's time to wake up. It's time to get this magic circle rolling.
All right.
Let's do
you
this.
You activate it. Yeah, I'm going to. Yep. Everybody get ready to jump in. That's
grab
a bigger
my arrows.
Circle.
Oh, that's a big ass circle.
Well, it's in.
It's inside of here,
in
yeah.
Middle. Yeah, yeah. So
we can't move under there ourselves, but yeah.
You can't? Oh,
nope,
yeah.
I can't physically
I
move
you,
into that range. Now
you.
We can.
I make sure that I'm behind Elise and that I can see that she is in the portal with us.
There you go. I've got you guys. No stress. No stress. So you
okay.
Activate
all
it.
Stress.
Yep.
You
I'll pump
it.
In a fourth level just to be safe.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
So.
And you activate it, the circle glows, and you all feel the power of teleportation pushing around you.
Where are we?
You find yourself in a crater, in a forest, and then as you all land, everyone's everything starts going off. Yeah. Isaac, you feel your stone start going off, your talking stone. Abaddon, you get the sense that you really should look in your book. And yeah, that's what you guys are feeling, and we're gonna deal with that next session.
How long has time passed?
You all are probably definitely back, at least in the material plane. Where you are, you're not sure, but you are back in the material plane. Yay! Congratulations on defeating the deep woods, forest, whatever it's called.
Back in the material plane.
Do I still have a job?
I hope you all had fun. Thank you so much for hanging out with us today, chat. And we will see you all again next time. I hope you all liked the new portraits. I posted them on Twitter. If you want to like
looks
them.
So pretty.
I think they look really sick. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
They look awesome.
I was sitting at like 20 live, like, man, it really suck if that thing tree blew up because she just got these portraits ready.
It was a 5-turn cooldown. So like unless it got around to turn 5 again, you were
fine. Got really close to getting around to turn 5.
It got through 4. Yeah, you right. But good night everybody. Thanks for hanging out. We'll see you next week. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.